Okay, so we have a rotating system, slows from 2.5 radians per second, 2.1 radians per second in 10 seconds, right? Now, going back to definitions, acceleration's rate of change of velocity with respect to time, you got to know those words, otherwise you won't be able to apply necessarily the definition of rate of change to other things as well, okay? And you might even make a mistake on this. Or equivalently, you could say the average acceleration in intervals, the average rate of change of velocity with respect to time. Now, the view of average velocity, our average rate of change of A with respect to B is change in A divided by change in B, right? Well, we can apply that here immediately. Average rate of change of velocity with respect to time is acceleration, right? Now, it also applies to angular acceleration. There's only, the only difference is the word angular, and of course then you're going to use angular accelerations. So I'm going to put angular in parentheses in front of every velocity so we can apply it to velocities or accelerations. Okay, so average rate of change of average rate of change of angular velocity with respect to time is what? And this is, of course, over delta t, not over 2. Very easy, because in a minute we're going to average the two angular velocities and figure out how far the thing went, right? And it's very easy to divide by 2 when you do that. I mean, you do that. You would divide by 2 in that case. Very easy to confuse whether you divide by 2 or by delta t. You just write it down because you're thinking of formulas rather than thinking about what happens. And you make a mistake, right? A terrible mistake that hopefully by carrying through the units and realizing your units didn't work out, you immediately go back and fix, right? Of course, you might not know how to fix it if you don't know these definitions. In this case, you probably would. In another case where you've got a definition of energy with respect to time or something like that, you could easily make a mistake, okay? Because everything is rates of change. Not everything, but a great deal of physics is involved in a rate of change of one quantity with respect to another. That's why calculus is so important. Okay, so anyhow, we have this. And of course it's delta t, and that's 10 seconds. So that equals negative 0.04 radians per second squared. Okay? Y'all are good about using units, I'm not worried about that, okay? And that is the unit of angular acceleration, so we recognize that our units have worked out. Now, units can work out even though you do the wrong calculation, so you got to make sure the calculation makes sense in terms of definitions, instead of doing it by habit. There's no time limit in the test. You don't have to do things by habit. You can think them through, okay? Okay, well, then what else can we determine from the given information and using basic definitions? And what definition would we use?